Here's a question for you. Can you see birds in trees with a thermal? Yeah, you can. I'm Dave from Thomas Jacks. I'll explain why thermal is an ideal tool for finding birds and share three tips to help you see with more clarity in trickier situations that are common to bird spotting. If you're thinking about thermal as a birder, I'll explain all with lots of thermal images of birds in trees. So, birds emit heat, and they're often found in trees, ground cover, grass or reeds for feeding or protection. Now, even if you hear a bird call, locating it with more traditional tools takes patience and time. Because thermal uses heat and not light to detect birds, it can see into the shadows between foliage. And camouflage is no obstacle, so thermal isn't just for finding things in the dead of night. All these thermal images are in daylight. But are there limitations? Well, just like a camera, a thermal can't see through solid matter. And it doesn't replace your understanding of habitats or bird behaviour. It also doesn't replace your binoculars or camera. But whatever level of birder you are, a thermal will improve your success rate of finding birds, so you've more opportunities to get your binoculars or camera on them. So what kind of thermal should you buy? Well, birds can be relatively small, and finding them can involve scanning around, so opt for a big sensor and a wide field of view. Something like the Pulsar Telos XL50 is ideal. A huge 1024 pixel sensor for fine detail and 14 degrees field of view. By comparison, the entry-level Pulsar Telos is more affordable and slightly more magnified, but that gives you a narrower field of view, and it has a smaller sensor, which is why the image isn't so clear. There's no question you can still spot the birds, but less definition means you might miss a few. Now, whichever thermal device you end up with, here are some tips for bird spotters that will definitely help you find more. And the first is this challenging scenario. It sounds like a blackbird, but I can't find it until I look through a thermal to reveal it had been obscured by the shadows that were tricky to see into because of that bright sky. Now, back to thermal, and the sky being a large cold area is a bit of a challenge for thermal too, which makes it harder to discern warm blackbird in amongst all those different temperatures in the tree. So here's tip number one. Toggle through some of your colour palettes. Each one uses shades and colours differently to depict minute temperature variations. Some define warm bodies better, others emphasise the mid-tones, while black hot and white hot are the best all-round palettes for most routine situations. Run through them if you're unsure what you're seeing is a bird or a bit of tree reflecting the sun, as each one can help build up a more complete picture. And now we've found our target, here's tip number two. Drop the brightness and increase the contrast. It's similar to adjusting the exposure on a camera to deal with that bright, cold sky. And just like going through the colour palettes, the process of finding a sweet spot often reveals enough to guide you where to point your binoculars. And tip number three is sensor amplification. For this, I'll pull up some stills so you have a side-by-side comparison of the same scene. The first is normal amplification, with the brightness and contrast at their midpoint. For the rest of them, I've lowered the brightness and increased the contrast as before. On normal sensor amplification, high amplification, and ultra, which is all indicated on the bar along the base of each screen view. Scan your eye over all of these views, and there's probably one that really draws attention to the bird for you. Hopefully that helps. I'll run through a few extra examples that use the same tips in different settings while I conclude. So a pulsar thermal can be a real asset to locating birds quicker. And that gives you more opportunities to identify them with your binoculars and more opportunities to photograph them. If you've any questions or tips of your own, add a comment below. If you'd like to find out about any pulsar thermal, like the Pulsar Telos XL50 you've seen in this video, visit tj-focus.co.uk. And to be notified about more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe. I'm David Thomas Jacks. Thanks for watching.